and welcome to the Q4 FY21 earnings conference call of Aero Granite Industries Limited, hosted by Kanav Capital Advisors. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Gaurav Sood from Kanav Capital Advisors Private Limited. Thank you, and over to you, Mr. Gaurav.
Thanks, Rutuja. Welcome, everyone, and thanks for joining this Q4 FY21 earnings call for Aero Granite Industries. The results and investor update has been mailed to you and is also available on the stock exchange. In case anyone does not have a copy of the press release, please do write to us and we will be happy to send it over to you. I hope all of you are safe and wish a good health for your family and you during this period of COVID-19 pandemic. To take us through the results of this quarter and answer your questions, we have today with us Mr. Sunil Kumar Arora, Managing Director, Mr. Sahil Arora, Full-Time Director, Mr. Madan Gopal, CFO, and Mr. Sabyasachi Panigrahi, Legal Head and Company Secretary. We will be starting the call with a brief overview of the company's performance, and then we will follow with a Q&A session. I would like to remind you all that everything said on this call that reflects any outlook for the future, which can be construed as a forward-looking statement, must be viewed in conjunction with uncertainties and risks that they face. These uncertainties and risks are included but not limited to what we have mentioned in the prospectus filed with SEBI and subsequent annual report, which you will find on our website. With that said, I now turn over the call to Mr. Sahil Arora. Over to you, Sahil.
Thank you, Gaurav. The management of Aero Granite Industries Limited would like to welcome you to the Q4 2021 investor con call. Thank you for taking your time to attend this call. Financial year 2020-2021 has been the pandemic year, with COVID-19 cases bringing most of the world to a complete standstill during various and numerous lockdown periods. The pandemic required companies to think on their feet and adjust quickly to ever-changing scenarios. Despite the challenges of COVID-19 and losing 6 weeks of sales to the lockdown, our sales grew from 177.71 crores rupees in FY19-20 to 179.37 crores rupees, with our net profit after tax increasing by over 68% from 3.6 crores in FY20-20 to 6.05 crores in FY20-21. The first half of the financial year was challenging for our company due to lockdowns resulting in shutdown of our plants for 6 weeks. Subsequently, we also faced raw material shortage due to the lack of labor inquiries, which impacted our sales in the first half of the year. As the economy opened up post the lockdown, the second half of this year improved, and we were operating at significantly improved levels, with sales in Q4 being the highest of the four quarters. Our Q4 sales has increased by 28.49% from rupees 43.6 crores in Q4 2020 to rupees 56 crores in Q4 2021, with EBITDA increasing by 90% from 4.45 crores in Q4 2020 to 8.49 crores in 2021, and profit after tax increasing by 496% from 0.47 crores in 2020 to 2.77 crores in Q4 2021. Once the country came out of lockdown, there were many issues to be tackled. Chief among those was the acute shortage of labor. Initially, there was no rail service or road service, and there were many interstate restrictions on travel. Hence, many of the migrant workers were not able to travel. This shortage of labor not only affected the factory operations, but also quarry operations, especially in the south of India. This reduced our production capacity in Hosur to a great extent, and in Jaipur, though to a lesser extent. The labor shortage, raw material shortage, made sales more complicated, And to make things worse, we are going through a world shipping crisis with container and ships in short supply. This has led to an exponential increase in cost, containers costing 2 to 4 times to various destinations. Some customers were hesitant to accept these increases initially, while many have now accepted it to be the new normal. During the year, our Jaipur plant contributed to 18% of our total revenue. Our portfolio of colors has significantly increased, increasing our volumes and customer base with the help of the new range of Rajasthan. This semi-exotic color range is very popular in North America, and we hope to continue scaling up operations in our Jaipur plant in the coming years. Vigo, our machine supplier for the quartz plant, helped us through CCTV and video conferencing support, and we were able to commission our quartz plant with commercial production starting in January 2021. Though there are many challenges due to travel restrictions worldwide, we have a strong distribution channel and a strong relationship with our customers built over 30 years. We are banking on these relationships and the trust they have on us to drive and accelerate our quartz labs, and we expect our quartz plant will contribute significantly to our business in the coming years. We have generated ₹2.3 crores of sales in Q4 2021 through quartz sales. We have positioned ourselves for growth in the future by widening our product offerings to include engineered stone along with natural stone. Our Jaipur plant and quartz plant will drive our future growth and help us in improving our margins. We would now like to open up this phone call for questions. Thank you very much. Hello.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
So we'll now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on the touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Siddharth Agrawal from Prudent Value Partner. Please go ahead.
Hi, good afternoon, sir, and thank you for giving me the opportunity. And congratulations, Sunil ji, for a good set of numbers. My first question is, our sales have been more or less flat this year in spite, and we have, you know, managed it quite well to at least manage the top line. But our profitability has gone up quite a bit. So what is the reason behind that, behind the margin expansion?
Actually, the difference between last year and this year, the other expenses has come down by 6 crores. From 8 crore of last year to 2 crores of this year is the forex loss. Last year we had a forex loss of 8 crore. This year we have the forex loss of 2 crore. That is why the difference in the profitability.
Okay, sir. And so we mentioned that our sales in domestic markets are going up. So can you please explain our business in Indian market and give some numbers of our domestic sales and profitability here?
Our domestic sales comprises of two components. One is a completely high-end segmented market where it's volume-wise a very small percentage of our sales, but value-wise it's quite high. And the other part is a sale of our export rejects. So we have two different markets that we are looking at. Both markets combined roughly contribute to about 8% of our total sales. Which has significantly grown since previous years. It's about 30%, 40% increase from the previous years. So looking at profitability, export rejects are sold at cost or just below cost, whereas the high end is a very profitable and very lucrative market, and we will look to expand that part in the future.
Okay. And sir, could you also give us some details about your inventory? I guess we have cleared a lot of old inventory during the COVID period. So could you give us some breakup of our inventory age-wise as of 31st March 21?
Yeah, see, we have cleared most of, see, we had more than 5-year-old stock, which we cleared everything. Now we have less than 3 years old stock. Actually, we clear our domestic sale. We cleared the inventory through domestic sale as well as exports. The domestic sale went up from 11 crore of last year to 16 crore of this year.
Okay.
So, we don't have any inventory at this, finished inventory at this point, which is older than 3 years.
Okay. Sir, and our Jaipur plant has been a good success, and it is, you know, very, heartening to know that, you know, we have started on a very good note here. So could you tell us about what is the capacity utilization in our Jaipur plant, and how much revenue or profitability we can expect at the optimal utilization here?
Jaipur plant is almost running at a full capacity. There we have started only with one multi-wire and the complete line, so which is already being fully utilized. And as far as margins are concerned, I'll tell our CFO to give the details.
Yeah, Jaipur contributed, we did a sale of 36 crore this year, and margin is about 40% in Jaipur.
Okay. Yeah. And sir, given the success of our Jaipur plant and the better availability of popular colors here in the region, so is there any plan to expand the capacity further in Jaipur?
We are thinking right now. As soon as we have some concrete plan, we'll definitely come out with it.
Okay. But we have enough land, etc. available, or do we need to do a clean field?
No, we have capacity to increase. We already planned for two multi-wires. We can double the capacity. But right now, we're just thinking on that. But the construction has been done for the double capacity.
Okay. And sir, lastly, if I may ask about the quartz plant. First of all, congratulations for starting production there. So can you talk a little bit about your strategy? What is your targeted market or raw material procurement and pricing on final product? So a little bit, you know, whatever details you can share about our quartz plant and, you know, our strategy there.
Sure. So our main business has always been in natural stone, which where we produce random granite slabs and tiles. So random granite slabs are exported to customers all around the world who are wholesalers who then further export it to, who further sell it to homeowners or fabricators. Quartz will also follow through in those same channels. So they will be going, we will be selling them to our existing customers who are wholesalers who will further sell it on to their the end user or the fabricator. So channel wise, you know, having long relationships with a lot of our customers, predominantly, I would say that our quartz sales is going to happen to our existing customers. So that's one great advantage that we have. On the raw material side, most of the raw material includes quartz powder, which is also known as filler, quartz grit, which both of these comprise about 90% of our total composition, and about 10% of polyester resin along with pigments and various other products. All of these products are sourced locally within India.
Okay. And so how does our pricing of our quartz compare with granite as well as other, you know, peers?
So granite has four major tiers. You have the low end of granite, which is significantly lower than quartz. You have the middle sector of granite, the upper sector, and the exotic range. So the exotic range is roughly about 3 or 4 times the price of quartz, whereas quartz is somewhere in between the upper range and the middle range of granite. So it competes in the major market or the major price segment of products.
Okay. So from, sir, reading more about the quartz demand, we understand that the demand in international market is quite huge for quartz. So are we looking at this as a, you know, growth trigger for us, and, you know, what kind of revenues can we expect from this segment for the next 3-4 years?
Yes, for sure. It's somewhere that we'd look to grow, especially in North America, where there's a 350% duty on Chinese quartz. So that is one area that we do look to have good growth, especially that since we have a strong customer base over there.
So we're basically looking at the U.S. market from India because of the duty factor. As far as other countries are concerned, we have to compete with China, which makes it a bit difficult.
Yeah. And the revenue, to be honest, until we travel, you know, we don't look at a large utilization of the plant. But I think we can look at roughly...
this year we have planned as around 30 CR is our estimate sales for this financial year.
Okay. Great, sir. Thanks a lot for patiently answering all the questions and wish you all the very best. I come back in.
Thank you so much. Our pleasure.
Thank you. Participants who wishes to ask a question may press star and one now. The next question is from the line of Shubham Pandey, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thank you for providing me the opportunity to ask the question. My first question is that, sir, you said that the government has changed and representation are made for the reopening of quarry. What should we expect from them?
So the government has just changed. We have to just wait and see. We cannot predict anything what the government does or does not do.
Because in Tamil Nadu, we just got the new government, DMK, which has come into power. So we are very hopeful that this government will be more positive in opening up the quarries, especially in Tamil Nadu, where we are located, our main plant, Hosur plant, so which will definitely benefit us in the shortage of raw material which we have been facing from last 5 to 6 years. With that, new quarries opening up will help us in increasing our production and sales.
Okay, and can we expect the 2014 level for the raw material?
It all depends on the quarries opening up.
And how soon they can open up. Yeah. I mean, the government has just come into power, actually. They're very positive. They have been giving us very positive signals that they'll start the new quarries at the earliest.
Okay, and my next question is that how are we operating now and we have reached the pre-COVID level?
Yes. In fact, you have seen our last year results, which are better than the previous year. And same way this year also, we are very hopeful that we'll do better than the previous year. Actually, like rest of the world, rest of the country, everyone has been affected with the COVID. But fortunately, our company, we are able to manage, like Sahil just explained, because of the goodwill and the trust the customers have on us. So they are still continue to buy from us during this pandemic time.
As we have positioned ourselves in a very good position with Jaipur plant and quartz plant operational, can we expect very good year FY 2022?
You know, as we are still not out of this pandemic, we can't really predict for the rest of the year.
We are very hopeful.
And our start has also been
hopeful that we'll do very well as soon as this pandemic is under control. Yeah. That's what the plans have been made with the quartz plant and the Jaipur plant in operation. We are very hopeful that we'll do much better, actually.
As long as there's no lockdown, I think this year should be a good year for us.
Okay, so thank you for answering all the questions patiently.
Thank you.
Participants, to ask a question, please press star and one now. The next question is from the line of Gaurav Sood from Kanav Capital Advisors. Please go ahead.
Sir. I wanted to specifically understand a bit more about the new quartz plant. How is the market acceptance of this plant in terms of the initial batches and the general customer response you got?
The general customer response has been quite positive. Though some of the challenges that we do face is that it is a manufactured product, so there is a certain perfection that is expected in this product. And it's very difficult to convey that through pictures and videos and samples. So unless customers actually see the entire product as a whole in front of them with their with you know in person, the sales becomes a lot easier once they see it personally. And once you know it starts as a as they pick it up or they add it to their range, then the continuous sales on that product has become is very easy. So currently we're doing okay. We're running at
basically we are started right now with the basic colors because you know as you know the Chinese people could not visit us, so they could not really give us the complete support which they were supposed to do along with the machinery. But online, yes, they are helping, but there is always a limitation how much they can help us online. So right now, we are only making the basic colors, which are lower price and margins are obviously less. The actual margin in this material is once we start making the high-end material in quartz, which is only expected that once we have the this Chinese people visiting us, as soon as the international travel starts. And then we can expect much better margins.
Okay, great to hear that, sir. So what is the potential revenue that you can generate out of the quartz plant given the current setup?
Yeah, this year our estimate is 30 CR for the quartz plant and 200 for the granite for both Jaipur and Hosur put together. Granite we are looking at 200 and this quartz we are looking at 30. Total 230 is our estimate. Hopefully there will be no further lockdowns.
Okay, so this is this 30 crores is going to be the max revenue that the quartz line can generate or the max?
No, not at all. This will be not the max actually. We are looking at our max will be around about 550.
Just to elaborate, 50 is based on the current setup that we have. But to increase our capacity, the only additional machines have to be added. The building and the rest of the facilities are already set up, already designed for 2.5 lines. 2.5 lines means that we can essentially triple our capacity.
Okay, so you're saying that at additional lines are added and the potential revenue could be 150 crores once all
yes,
everything
absolutely
is.
Right, yeah, absolutely right.
Yeah,
and so the other part is on engineering stones, once you have the high-end material also coming out, would the red margins in this product be better than granite?
Just like all high-end, yes. For high-end, we can expect better margins. But same way, also on high-end natural stone, we have very good margins.
Okay. But what would be the breakup between base-end and high-end? You have any expected breakup between the two or...
To balance the plant, you need to have some basic, some medium type, some high end. So that's why we have a planning eventually to have 2.5 lines, where one line would run for basic, half line would run for the super high end, and one line would run for that medium range product. So, I mean, in the short term, we are basically doing the basic and our Carrara series, which is the medium range. The breakup between the two is... roughly about 20% medium range and 80% basic. But as we become, as once the Chinese technicians can come and improve our, can teach us how to make the high end, we will have to see the market. The market potential is huge for the high end, so we'll have to see what will be best suited at that time.
So Sahil, these products, quartz products, you plan to sell them as generic slabs or you plan to build a brand around that?
Most of our customers are wholesalers in their own, on their own, and most of them now have their own in-house brand as they prefer to buy from various factories from various countries and have the best selection out of those and then to bring it into their warehouse and brand it themselves. To make a brand is a huge expense.
But some customers we already started.
Yeah.
Like in Slovakia, we have started with our own brand name. Netherlands, with one customer, we started with our own brand name. USA is the only market, which is a bigger market. We need some time to really start with a brand name. But right now, to begin with, these are the two places where we started branded. And USA, we are going by whatever the customer requirement is.
So what do you call your brand, sir, in this case?
Arrow Quartz. Very simple. Yeah.
Arrow what, sir?
Arrow Quartz.
Arrow Quartz, yeah.
Arrow Quartz.
Yeah.
Okay. And And sir, given that this product is made by Chinese lines vis-a-vis the Britain lines, which are the established benchmark, how much of an impact is there on the finish? And whether you expect similar realizations to those products?
There's no impact on the finish because the finishing is done by Italian machines. Our molding process is done by Chinese machine, but our finishing is done by Italian machines.
Quality is same like
and
what Baton machine is.
Yeah.
So absolutely same quality.
Absolutely the same. It's just a different size of machinery.
So over time, you expect similar realizations. You should not, given that the finish is similar. So.
Absolutely. As long as we're able to make high-end material, we can have similar realizations for sure. Whatever Italian machinery or Baton machinery is giving, exactly the same thing can be done with this machinery.
Okay. That's great to hear. Sir, and given that America had put the anti-dumping duty on China with regards to this particular product line, how is that impacting demand? Is a lot of demand for quartz coming out of US for Indian quartz?
Yeah, absolutely. Because China is a behemoth that produces everything in the world. So once you close off a certain market, they have to find alternatives, and India is the best alternative to that.
Okay. Okay, that kind of sums up my set of questions. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Participants, to ask a question, please press star and one. The next question is from the line of Chirag Sen, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi sir. I would like to know the status of the current debt which you have and what would be your timeline with regards to repayment of the same.
Can you please repeat your question?
Sir, the status of the current debt, what is the current debt which you have on books and the timeline with regards to repayment going forward?
Yeah. Funny, you want to take it or shall I?
Yes. Going forward, the entire debt will be repaid by 2027.
27, yes.
Okay. And
yes.
Currently, what is the debt on books?
Debt on books, as of today, if I say it is around...
I will tell you.
Yes.
We have 52 crores total. Out of that, HDFC term loan is 20 crore.
Mm.
And what we have taken for Jaipur is 29.
Mm.
3 crore is the supplier credit, Vigo. 2.8 crore. So total debt is 52 crores.
And repayment will be by the year.
Okay, Vigo, the supplier credit will get over by September
21. Okay.
And HDFC, we have a 7-year repayment period, which started from March 21. So it ends 2027, as Panigrahi stated.
And sir, what will be the working capital limits currently?
We have a working capital limit of 105 crores.
Total 120 crores.
Total 120.
120 crores. From
110 in Bank of Baroda and 10 crores in HDFC.
HDFC.
But this entire is it PCFC? It's in foreign currency.
Yes.
Okay. So your total would be, including everything, would be about 170 crores.
Yes.
Yeah.
And what would be the current cost of debt, sir?
Our interest cost is 4 crores per annum, all put together.
Okay.
Yeah.
So for working capital, our interest cost is very low. Why? Because we only borrow PCFC,
foreign
currency loan, which is LIBOR plus...
Which is linked to LIBOR, 1.5%.
Plus LIBOR plus 1.5%, which works out to be 2.5-3% maximum.
Yes.
In Euro, it is much less. Dollar is a little bit. So overall, our interest cost in working capital is very low. So our interest cost is mainly for the term loan, what we have for Jaipur and Quartz loan.
Okay. And sir, my second question would be regarding your margins. Sir, and you know, in the industry, when you look at competitors, they have been operating at a higher margins.
Your voice is not clear. Can you please repeat that?
Just a second.
Yeah, hello. Am I audible now?
Yeah.
I just wanted to inquire about the margins. If you look at the industry, the competitors are currently operating at much higher margins. So when do we scale up with regards to that margins? Because currently also, as you told, you're not operating at full capacity. So going forward in this year, supposedly there is issues. Would we be able to have better margins also with regards to your increase in top line guidance which you've given?
Actually, our problem was availability of the raw material.
Actually, we lost the margin 4-5 years when slowly the quarries had closed down in the Tamil Nadu, where we are, our main plant is situated for granite. So once the blocks are not available, we have to source those blocks from the other states. So the cost of transportation, higher cost of blocks, so that impacted our profitability as compared to the other manufacturers. But once the quarries open up in Tamil Nadu, we'll definitely be able to make same margins. But as far as Jaipur is concerned, as far as quartz is concerned, we are making better margins than our competitor.
Yeah, because now with the Jaipur plant getting operational, now sourcing would also not be an issue because no transportation required.
That's what I'm trying to explain to you. If you bifurcate our business into four parts, you know, we have four verticals. One we do is granite tiles, which we are doing from last 30 years. There our margins are pretty reasonable. It's been same for many, many years. Number two is the granite slabs, which you do it in Hosur, where margins are less because of the non-availability of blocks. Number three is our Jaipur, again granite slab, where margins are very good because where the blocks are available, and we have good market for that. Number four is, which we've just started now, quartz plant. Quartz plant we've just started this year in January only. So slowly we'll scale up and we'll make better margin in quartz, same like other manufacturers.
So blended would be on the higher side for the current year?
Sorry,
pardon? So your blended margins, overall blended margins would be on the higher side?
We are very hopeful actually.
Because as you said earlier also, in Jaipur, you're operating at about 40% margins.
Right.
So that is where the difference immediately is between, as you told, with regards to Hosur and with regards to Jaipur. So supposedly if things are online, so the blended margins and on the overall picture with regards to the current year would be better?
Yeah, we are very hopeful. But again, like I said, for the Hosur plant, still there is a shortage of blocks. And quartz plant, I mean, we just started actually. I mean, we started with the without the help of the technicians coming from China. We are doing it online. So we are facing daily issues in running the plant. Actually. So it will take some time for us to scale up actually. But if not this year, next year definitely we are very hopeful of having much, much better
and
margins.
This year there is still a lot of shortage of labor as transportation and things open up. We have to see what effect that will have on labor on both the plants.
Sir, but Q1, are we operating fully or how is it with regards to the current Q1 which is just gone by? Quarter one, are we operating at a decent capacity as compared to last year?
You know, but no, Q1, as you know, there has been a lockdown. Though this time, 100% EOU were exempted from the lockdown. So we were allowed to work, but under a lot of challenges. Challenges means there is no public transport, our people could not come to the factory. We had many cases in our factory. In fact, we lost four of our employees in this COVID time. There are many cases where they were hospitalized. We had to look after them. No, this has been a very challenging this quarter. This quarter has been the most challenging, but we still did much. I mean, only thing I would say that we are still doing pretty well, actually, compared to the circumstances, compared to the problems which we are facing. We are still doing pretty well, actually.
Thank you, sir. Yeah.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, to ask a question, you may press star and one. Participants to ask a question may press star and one. The next question is from the line of Siddharth Agrawal from Prudent Value Partner. Please go ahead.
Hi, thank you for giving me the opportunity again. Sunilji, could you give us some color on the demand scenario in the US? From whatever we read, that the home housing market is very hot and a lot of redevelopment is going on. So what kind of demand are we seeing from our dealers, our networks over there, to our wholesalers? And what is sort of inventory levels over there? If you give us any color or over there, which which can give us some idea of the potential demand in the coming years.
So, speaking specifically about the US market, the demand is extremely high at the moment, purely, firstly because there was a lot of funds given by the government to the public. At the same time, your expenses also reduced. So, though there might not be a huge amount of new house purchase, but there's a lot of renovation market going on right now. So, the initial post-lockdown impact on our customer, the wholesaler, was that they were short on inventory. So, there was immediate push for a huge amount of volume requirement at the beginning of the last financial year. And as the year went by, they saw that the renovation market continued to be strong, and that created a lot of demand for them. There's still a lot of work from home going on in many parts of the world, including India, including the US. So when you're in a situation where you're working from home, you're spending a huge amount of time in your own personal surroundings, you start to notice the smallest of things. So changing your kitchen, remodeling your bathroom, those become a huge priority for you because your apartment building, your bedroom, your kitchen, that becomes your entire world, and that's your world, you know, for 24/7, 365 days. So that has driven a huge demand, not only in the US, but in various parts of the world, wherever finances are available, especially from the government.
Okay. But have the inventory levels at the dealers, wholesalers, etc. normalized now? Or, how is the order book, etc. looking now? The inquiries?
Yeah, the inventories at the customers are still at a very low level. And that also has to do a lot with the world shipping crisis that's going on right now. The availability of containers at extremely high prices, two, three times the pre-COVID values. Where we're talking about, you know, $2,000 containers to parts of the U.S. have now become $6,000 containers. They're still not readily available. So the transit times are taking longer. The availability of container is still extremely short. A lot of ports, a lot of destinations are, you know, not able to get enough containers. So with that in mind, you know, the wholesalers are still very short in stock.
Okay, so but does that mean that we also have a very strong order book that, you know, as soon as, you know, there is better logistic availability, a lot more goods could be shipped out?
Yeah, for the past 6-7 years, we have never had an issue with the order book. Our issue is on the raw material and being able to fulfill those order books. So even as of today, our Hosur plant is ready to run 100% based on the current orders that we have. It all depends on the raw material available to us. So if raw material availability improves, the order book will still continue to improve.
Okay. Great, sir. Thanks a lot for your answer.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Shubham Pandey, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Providing me the opportunity again. My question is that how is the cut to size and quality side business segment doing?
We are absolutely full. We are running at almost full capacity in our cut to size department. It's picked up well, especially in Europe, where we're doing a lot of small, medium, and medium sized projects. And I think that's one area that maybe in the future we can grow some more. But as of right now, we are running at good capacities.
Okay, and sir, our Jaipur plant must have high transportation cost. How are our margin in Jaipur plant as compared to Hosur?
Our Jaipur plant has lower transportation cost because we are only focusing on quarries that are within Rajasthan, so within the state itself. Hosur, we are buying material from Andhra, Telangana, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and also we are importing a lot of raw material from Brazil, Norway, Finland, and bringing them to India. So the transportation costs, the absolute transportation costs in Rajasthan are far lower than that in Hosur.
Okay, and my one last question is, in Q4 FY21, we did say sale of 2.3 crore. And what is the sale in Q1 FY22 in quartz? Are we doing better?
This year we are planning to, this financial year, we have a estimate of sales in quartz is 30 crore.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, to ask a question, you may press star and one. Please press star and one to ask a question. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one. As there are no further questions from the participants, I now hand the conference over to the management for closing comments.
Thanks everyone for participating on the phone call. Your questions are very important to us and help us communicate better. As we all know, things are very difficult with the COVID situation around the world. And we hope that everyone is keeping safe and healthy. And we hope for a better future together. Stay vaccinated, stay safe, and get vaccinated as soon as possible. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of Kanav Capital Advisors, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.